three diamonds, part of the golden age, or two, part two, that's what it says here. So Guts is returning to old favor, warms Casca's shivering body. Casca's shivering body with his own. They spend time recovering, but the blue whales have caught up with them. In the anime, if you guys ever watched the Berserk anime, then you'll notice that this scene's pretty... It's key to the development of not only Casca's relationship between Guts and Casca. There's a turning point after this point with them getting this close with each other, because Guts saved Casca, and then you'll see after, if you haven't watched the anime, you'll see after this scene what happens. But yeah, the relationship, this is a turning point, and it's a key point, the relationship with both of them. So yeah, I'm going to be playing this mission, we'll see what happens. And you can play as Guts, and just Guts in this one mostly, yeah, because he's fending off the mercenaries that are coming after him. So yeah, I hope you enjoy the stream, and you'll see what's going to happen right now. So this is a flashback scene right now with Casca. This is what happened to her, unfortunately. So I don't understand why it's so jumpy, this scene. But they're trying to probably cut back on the cutscene right now. She's probably a servant or enslaved. And he tries to rape her, you see, in the scene. And then this is how she meets Griffith. He saves her. But really, he gives her the option to save herself. So it's an empowering moment for Casca's character. It's an empowering moment for any woman that's a fan of the series, you know. So be like, yeah, woman power. You know, she saved herself, and he gave her the option. Live by the sword or die by the sword. It's going to happen right now. And then he sort of tries to jump on her. Oddly enough, instead of running away. And then, he falls on the sword, and, she empowers herself by, taking that nobleman's life. And that's how she develops a deep feeling for Griffith in this scene here.
Hey.
He's just telling her what happened.
Oi, baka. Mada yokon natte ro.
Netsu ga sagarishite ne en dakara yo. Nukara ro.
Shouga ne daro. Zubun nure de omake ni kogoe kakete tan dakara yo.
She's telling her, you know, she's going to freeze to death. You had to keep her warm.
Oh my
god. Boom! Oh! She doesn't like the fact that he's seen her naked. But he had to do what he had to do to keep her alive, you know? Oh! And, she still has hard feelings for him.
But
even at this point, it's not the first time they've been naked with each other, because she actually had to. She was ordered by Griffith before this to keep him warm when he was running a fever after being cut up by Griffith in a sword fight. She feels empowered, and she doesn't want to be saved by a guy at this point. And she just fainted because, yeah, she's still weak and hasn't recovered from her fever. Okay, so now everything has changed. I met Griffith. Even now, I feel like it's been a long dream. She's doing a lot of self-reflection in this scenario. I want to be by his side. I want to be essential tool for cutting his own path towards his dream. And I believe that someday I wish come true. I was able to believe until that day appeared. So, with the last time with my stream, that was kind of like a crucial moment where Griffith pretty much told Charlotte, the princess, he told her that, you know, no man that chases after his own dream is not equal to him. And it stuck with Guts. You know, he felt a little bit of ill will or resentment towards the Griffith for saying that, because he's been loyal to him. He proved himself after he wanted to go on and do his own thing, but then challenged him. You know, he's been loyal to him for years up to that point. And for Griffith to say that, you know, he feels some resentment towards that. And she's reflecting on what he said too. And, you know, in her own path that she's taken by being at the side of, and loyal. She's been loyal to Griffith too, herself. Do you remember what Griffith said to you on top of that hill? I want you, Guts. Griffith has never said that like that to anyone. Because her and herself, she feels like she was picked by Griffith. You know, and she feels really endeared to him and really loyal to him. Like Guts developed that loyalty to Griffith. But she feels like she should always be number two, second to Griffith. Right. And yeah, it was deep feelings, you know. Both of them actually have that in common, you know, like that will, that devotion towards Griffith, you know, for what kind of person he is. But now Guts is kind of wavering, you know. Why, what does it have to be? She actually feels resentment towards Guts for not appreciating the position that he's in right now as a character in the, or as a person in the Band of the Hawk, because she feels like her position is being challenged by Guts. You know, she doesn't understand why he chose Guts, but, you know, or Guts, you know. So that is your dream. The pursuers are here. The mercenaries are after them, you know. And, yeah, so in this scene, you'll see the mercenaries go after Guts and Casca. So I have to flee until I catch up with the, you know, the Band of the Hawk. So, or I have to fend them off, I think. Yeah, in this scene, he's fending off a bunch of guys. And yeah, so I'll be fending off and cutting down a lot of guys until backup arrives, I think. That's how the anime goes. You'll probably see a cutscene to explain that. So I just gotta equip some weapons, maybe change something up. I'll leave that. So let's increase your attack level. More horses. There's not a horse in this scene, I don't think. Okay, so I'll just start the battle and gameplay. Okay, yeah. So he's alone. There's no horses in this scene, at least on his side. And we don't have any more time to waste. So Casca's still weak from her fever that she drew up. Break through the enemy lines. Okay. I think I gotta protect Casca. Oh, she's following me, so. Yes, you see her health bar's at half, so they're trying to be really accurate to this part of the story in the anime/manga. Because if you're a Berserk fan, you obviously know that the manga and the anime are really close to each other. They haven't really changed too much about it. Like, maybe the art's different at best, but it's pretty accurate. You know, it's not like other animes and manga translations or transitions, I mean. Camp, I don't think we could just take them head on. We have to take them down before they make any noise. So this is sort of different, actually, from the anime, actually, because like army camp, like in this scene, Casca, I keep forgetting that. Okay, so he's done still. Oh, there's plenty of more.
仕事はきっちりこなさないとな。ったく、実際迷惑な話だぜ。女ってのはよ、どう考えたって向いてねえ戦になる。お前に何が分かる。分かるわけねえだろ。男なんだ。分かってんのはよ、お前の女の都合で足止め食うわけにいかねえってことだ。
Okay, I just gotta pause it for a minute because my internet connection's kind of dropping. It's telling me on the stream, so let me just turn off something on my phone because I was streaming actually a video of some Twitch person off my phone just to support them. So I just dropped that stream, so it doesn't affect my own stream that I'm broadcasting right now. So that improved. So if you've seen a drop in the stream, that's why. Okay, so yeah, I still have the mercenaries chasing after me, but it makes it seem like we're cutting through an enemy like camp, or the army's camp, but opposition's camp, but that's not really the case in the anime manga. Now I have a horse, which didn't really happen in the anime. You know, so I guess they're trying to make it more feasible in the video game. They could have done it where the mercenaries came after us. So where's Casca right now? Wait, I'm going back more because I'm not sure what's going on with this. Okay, so she went up ahead. Okay, now this is accurate to what happened, but he didn't have a horse still. Okay, so I got a protector. Her moving around doesn't really help me. Okay, where is she? Okay. Okay, so I'm leveling up for my super power thing. Okay, so they just keep coming. Escort Casca to target destination. Hey, my view's messed up. Oh, she went ahead and still. I gotta follow her because, yeah, this is kind of ridiculous right now. Where does she go? Because I gotta protect her, so, yeah, she's by herself now. That's great. Killed that enemy officer now. Okay, I don't know. Wait, where is she? She's back there. Two enemy officers that appear now. Okay, so I'm powering up. Where's it? Gaska? Oh, this guy, he actually got a hit on me. Oh. Okay, he's done. Okay, 500 kills. And where did Casca go? Here. Okay, two more officers appeared, so power up. I'm missing them. Super power up. Where's Casca? And what's in here? Yeah. I think, those two officers are down now. Jesus. They should have cut down on the speed with the horse, I think. It's kind of exaggerated, the speed level. Because it doesn't keep up with the camera too well, I find. That's really set back with this game. I think it's overkill with the speed level, with the movement with the horse. The camera is definitely not keeping up with it. Yeah, it's really jittery, I find. Okay, so that guy's not dead yet. Slaughtered them, so... It is a grind, but that's what these types of games are. He actually hit me. She follow me? Yeah, she. Okay, so I think she does follow me. Oh, he hit me. Oh. Yeah. Where do I gotta go? She's following me, but okay. Just, I'm a little lost here, so I think it's up here. Oh, I'm going the wrong way again. Doesn't seem like they're attacking her. It's just protect her, but okay. I think it's this way. Oh, that's cool. Okay, so more enemies. Nice. For you? Okay, where's Casca? I lost Casca. Oh, there she is. You got me. Okay, I got over 1,000 kills now. This is getting kind of tiresome. You got me. Oh. Yeah, that guy's done. Let's break this up now. Okay. Oh. Move a little forward. Yeah, I think she went ahead without me. Oh, that's not good. Oh, he took me down. See if they fall off a cliff if I hit them. Oh, cool, yeah. If they do fall off. Oh, no. Oh, he took me down. That's two officer zombies. Bastard. Super power up. barely any guys left. Okay. Get that. Let's get out of here. Okay, it's done. And that's that. Oh, now it's the mercenaries yet. So it's just a bunch of archers, so they can still do a lot of damage. Okay, there's the officer. Hey, come back here. We're not done yet.
Oh,
I'm blocked from going after him. I gotta fight Padon now. Okay, one on one. Let's go. Let's go, boy. Yeah, boy. Nice. Comes in swinging. You're in trouble now. Boom. Oh, he's got backup. Super power up. Boom. How about that? Yeah, boy. Come at me, bro. He's almost done. I got you by your bootstraps, boy. And he knocked me down. Okay, superpower. Boom. He's done. Victory. Donna is successfully defeated. He'll probably do a cutscene now. Yep. Band of the Hawk has shown up.
やべんじゃねえのか。ガッツ。おい。死ぬなって言ったろ。お前は私との約束を破るのか。ガッツ。うっせえな。ゆするんじゃねえ。傷に染みんだろうが。
So this is the turning point, actually. She feels more affection for him and for what he did. He saved her, so... They also skipped a scene where... when he was giving her body heat inside the tree, they actually ended up making out, so they totally skipped that part of this element of the game. So, you know, like, they forgot to mention that, and you know that they've developed a romantic relationship right in between this scene here. So that's the only cutscene they actually left out. It's kind of crucial to the story development. Gameplay not so much, you know, like, because you choose just one character to play as, depending on what scene it is, you know. So, yeah, that's it. I was just going to do a quick stream of this because this game's really repetitive with the hack and slash stuff. And it's a good game, don't get me wrong. It's just, yeah, it's really repetitive for me to play a really long time with this game. So I'll stream this some another day. So it might be tomorrow or whenever, I don't know yet. I hope you enjoyed the stream, and yeah, that's it for now. You know, let's see here if it shows anything else up. What?
Guts, その.
Hurry your injuries. It's not something you should worry about compared to what you're doing. Me fighting 100 men, it doesn't really matter. More like 1,000. They exaggerated in the game. What do you mean? I ain't just you. Griffith's the same way. You both got something you bet your entire life on. But for me, if I go and fight 100 or 1,000 men, it's not really a big deal. That's what I thought. Everyone here has their own dreams. Little flames that would scatter if you blew on them. And they brought them here together to throw themselves in the biggest bonfire, blazing inferno named Griffith. But my flame isn't here. As for me, maybe I'm just warming myself by the campfire for a bit. So when it comes to the story, yeah, Guts was always half baked because he as a kid he was betrayed by somebody that wasn't his father, but he looked after the guy like a father figure, you know, and then he sort of went on his own, and then he met up with the Band of the Hawk due to reasons that, you know, I think in one battle he took their bounty, or what happened was he took not the bounty, was it the bounty? Yeah, he took the bounty head of one of the head generals in one of the fights, and the Bandit Hawk mercenaries kind of took issue with that, some of the soldiers, so they went after him, and then he ended up fighting them off. They had a hard time killing them. And then Griffith seen his talent with fighting, so he's like, Not only did you see him fight off the one army, but then he seen him fight off his own Band of the Hawk guys that are like upset with him taking the bounty. So then, yeah, he thought, you know, why not just recruit the guy? So then, he made a deal with him. You know, if he couldn't beat him off or beat him in a one-on-one match, then he would have to become what happened. So he's been sort of half-baked with the idea of staying with the Band of the Hawk. Up to this point, he kind of, kind of made him think more over and about that and self-reflect even more, you know. Like, now he has actual reason for not sticking with the Band of the Hawk because he wants to pursue his own goals, you know, his own dream, per se. Nothing beyond how to wield a sword. Just because I didn't want to die, just because of my sword around it, I kept fighting. And I have always left the most important part, the part that is called the reason to fight for other people you decide for me. Guts, you... Hey, Guts. You don't mean you're planning on leaving the Band of the Hawk. So this is also a turning point, not between the relationship between Guts and Griffith, but also like a turning point between just the Band of the Hawk in general. Like I'll stream this another day. So next one's the Battle of Doldry. I think they kind of progressed a little bit with that scene. Progress the storyline a little bit too much. But yeah, the Battle of Doldry is, this is like an important part of the storyline too. It's one of the biggest battles that they fight to fend off, the Empire of Tudor. And what happens after this point? This might be the main point where their kingdom. How's it go? Jeez, yeah. Sorry for the stuttering and stuff. Yeah. So the way the story goes is, yeah. I'm trying to just because I haven't watched the anime in a while. So I'm trying to remember the exact point. So in this point of the story, they defeat the kingdom. Like sorry for the spoilers, but you know, if you're tuning into the stream, you obviously watched the manga before. So then, beyond this point, they have peace in the kingdom. So I didn't want to really jump ahead, but you know, that's the battle. And then you'll see a turning point with the Band of the Hawk after this point. It's a turning point to the relationship with the Band of the Hawk and Guts, and then also like another turning point between the kingdom's relationship with the Band of the Hawk. So you'll see that. Or this might be the battle before this actually makes the Band of the Hawk knights at this point, because I think they're jumping ahead with Guts thinking about leaving the Band of the Hawk. I think they jumped ahead and actually by that previous scene that you just seen there. Okay, so I'm done streaming and I kind of jumped ahead, but I'm trying to explain how the story is compared to the anime. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed me streaming the Band of the Hawk for the PS or Berserk the Band of the Hawk for the PS4. I'll see you later.